Resident Evil. Dun dun dun. It's like one of those tests, isn't it, where you gotta look into that special light and see if you like wince or not. Wince? Christ. Blinded. So what's been in the news lately? There's that bloke who's done acting, isn't there? And they say he's got Asperger's and he shouldn't go to America because over here you get like what, a week in jail. And he says he's looking for UFOs and he's just walking to those sites. And they say he's an ill person and America wants to lock him up forever. I feel like America's overreacting. The security's that good, it should be better than some dude on his own getting through like that. I mean, doesn't make sense. Doesn't matter how good he is or how ill he is. I mean, if we're walking in the special top secret sites, and that's sort of. So I'm gonna go with Keeping Me Out. Yes, I don't know what his name is now. The Great English Hacker. Yeah, Keeping Me Out, Judging Me Out. Yeah, why not? Or extradition. I think America's got the arm grip on them, the extradition bit of all that stuff that's gone on lately. Yeah, there's a lot could be released, man. It's all that fighting about. They've made Scotland semi-autonomous, and you know the way things are with the left wing in charge, but they've been in charge for the last, was it 12 years now? So things are pretty well screwed up now. And let Scotland deal with everything. And some people are saying it's fine, and you know, Scottish people are saying it's because he's supposed to die and all this stuff. And other people saying, in England, saying, death's death, there shouldn't be any leniency. And he's been welcomed back home. I don't know, it's confusing. It's confusing. Because there's a lot of talk about him not being guilty in the first place. And my experience of British justice is that they do grab the nearest bloke and they do get things wrong. That's my experience. And there's not a lot of thinking going on. You think, oh my God, there's research and stuff. Nah, it's more like bludgeoning, really. It's like you get something wrong and just carry on bludgeoning it and hope no one knows. It's like same in the NHS. And I've got a good experience of them and all. They get stuff wrong, you don't get no compensation, and they just keep bludgeoning it through, saying, lessons will be learned, now go away, just die. That is the NHS. The National Health Service of Great Britain, woohoo, isn't it great? For some, for others, it shuts you up and kills you off. Right, so apparently, it's supposed to be about 25,000 Helmand Province voters in Afghanistan we could have had. And so we lost 10 soldiers over that, trying to get them to vote. And this great drive for democracy in Afghanistan, we shouldn't be doing that. We're there to stop a force destroying us. That's not, we're not there to run the country. We shouldn't be there to run people around the world running countries. That's some sort of police force effect you should possibly have. And it takes too way long to sort this stuff out. And it's gonna take what? And forever now. That's policing the bloody world. You could do that for every loads of countries all around the world could in that sort of position. Once they don't look a threat to Britain, you pull out. Then any women that want to pull out, then bloody go. You know, you can't fix countries like that. The only way you fix that, Afghanistan, is because it's all hills. Hills, hills, hills. You flatten all the hills. All that Helmand Province and all that, you make it a big car park. Chop all those bloody hills off and flatten it. You get some big, heavy diggers in. That's what they do all the time. Hide behind the hills. Why lose men for the next, say you're going to lose thousands of men, right? Say you're going to lose 2,000 men over the next, what, 50 years checking that place out. Wouldn't it be better North Pakistan, just to turn it into a flat car park. How easy will it be to catch and see the dudes then? How much poppies are they going to grow then? You know, you have a little, you know, like square off little fields. Well, still flat though. Square off little fields and they can grow some bloody stuff and get to flatten the bloody joint. And you're going, oh, but John, how's the water going to come down the hills and grow this stuff? Well, they ain't going to grow poppies in, are they? They're all flat. Give them a few little mounds here and there. Yeah, flatten it. Because all they do, they have the caves, and they hide behind the caves, they hide in the caves, you know, behind the rocks. You've got it all flat. That's sorted out, isn't it? So it's thousands of blokes. I mean, if you do other stuff around the world, you should be able to do that. All right, don't flatten everything, perhaps, you know, just knock down a few of the big mountains or, well, you know, have a go, like, yeah, knock it down. That's my solution to Afghanistan. That and pull out of there. We've had 10 bloody soldiers die for what, who voted? 150 votes. Because they threaten to chop their fingers off and do worse, whatever. Because they're walking around, they're eating five fingers. Yeah, so 10 soldiers died for 150 votes. Now, if that was any town in village, about 150, isn't it? It's a village. And you said, oh, look, let's, we've got to collect the votes from there. We better send 11 people in each time, though, in the van to collect the votes. Because 10 are going to get blown up on the way out. You just say, fuck you, we're not, you don't deserve a bloody vote. If that was any place in village in England, those 150 people, we'd be told to get out of there. And that was it. Otherwise, you ain't getting a bloody vote. It's not worth 10 bloody lives each time they want a bloody vote. Do you know what I mean? It's like the sacrifice of the olden Greek mythology. We need 10 hostages or sacrifices to, in order democracy. No, you just wouldn't do it, would you? You wouldn't do it here, so why you got to do it out there? That's not democracy, it's bloody murder, it's stupid. No.